How do I find the upper bound of the range for this function? Let's have a look. So firstly, I'm not sure why we have to find the upper bound of a range. If you want to find upper bound of a range, well, you have infinitely many different answers. Because for example, I can say 1 million or like 2025, they will all work. I'm pretty sure you're trying to find the least upper bound for the range. Then in that case, we can do the following. So notice that we have x squared over x squared plus 1. If we do this, on the top, just add 1 and then minus 1, and then over this denominator, and then that denominator, same thing, write it twice. This is just 1. This is just like a fast way to do the long division of a polynomial. So notice here, this is 1, it's constant, and here we just have a number, even though it's minus, over x squared plus 1. Imagine if x is infinity or negative infinity, this term will go to 0. So the function is always going to be 1 subtracting something like positive. This right here, it's always positive, by the way. So the biggest that it can possibly get is just 1, and then we are done. So that will answer your question. However, I would like to actually find a range for you, to be exact. So let's have a look. So firstly, the range of a function is all the possible y values. Here is what we have, and I assume that we are not going to do any derivative. I don't know why, but in fact, you don't really have to do any derivatives. We can just do this from an algebra approach. That is, we are going to find y so the equation y equals x squared over x squared plus 1 has real solutions. So here, let me just give you an example real quick. Imagine if y is equal to 2. Can that work? 2 is equal to x squared over x squared plus 1. Well, if I multiply this to both sides, I get 2 times x squared plus 1 equals x squared. This is not going to work. Have a look. Subtract square to both sides, and then subtract 1 to both sides. Here, we need to get x squared is equal to negative 1. And of course, this right here, it has no real solutions. Okay, so as you can see, this will tell us that 2 is not in the range of the function. So it won't work. Okay, how can we find all the possible y values so that the equation has real solutions? Let's have a look. So let's do the usual business. I'm going to multiply the denominator, x squared plus 1 to both sides. This times that, we just have y times x squared plus 1. This times that, they cancel, so that's equal to x squared. Now, distribute the y, we have y x squared plus y, and that is equal to x squared. Remember, we are trying to make sure that this equation has real solutions for x. So what we have here now is actually a quadratic equation in terms of x. Let me subtract x squared to both sides. And we can see this is y x squared minus 1x squared. We can factor out the x squared. The coefficient is y minus 1 and x squared. And right here, because we're looking at this as a quadratic equation in terms of x, do we have any x? No. We don't have any x term. So let me purposely emphasize that with the plus 0x. And then plus y, and that is equal to 0. Well, the reason I did that is because now we can use the quadratic formula. Yes, usually you can just use the quadratic formula instead of the square root, which is the discriminant, to make sure that this right here has real solutions. But I really want to show you guys with the quadratic formula. You will see why in a second. Anyways, here is our a, 0 is the b, and c is the y, a is y minus 1. So by the quadratic formula, we know x is equal to negative b, which is negative 0. It's just 0, by the way, of course, plus or minus square root b squared, that's 0 squared, minus 4ac, a is y minus 1, and c is y, all over 2 times a, which is y minus 1. So if we did have a good value for y, then x would be something like this. Now we have to make sure that For what y will make this actually nice? Firstly, look at that we have y minus 1 on the bottom multiplied by 2. So right away, we will have to know that y is not equal to 1 because otherwise we are dividing by 0. And this is why I really want to show you guys what's the quadratic formula. If you just look at the discriminant, which is the inside of the square root, in order for x to be real, we have to make sure this right here is non-negative. Therefore, right here, we will have to say, let me just still write this down, 0 squared minus 4 times y minus 1 times y, it has to be greater than or equal to 0. We said that to be greater than or equal to 0. And now we just have to work this out to find the conditions for y. 0 squared doesn't matter. We can divide both sides by negative 4, make it slightly easier. Cancel these things. And this is just y minus 1 times y. That is, switch the inequality, so it becomes less than or equal to 0. Now, depends on how you want to solve it. You care about two numbers here. Or you can just use the graph, doesn't really matter. You care about 1 because that will make this 0. And you care about 0 because that will also make this 0. So draw a number line, test it out. Let's say 0 is here, 1 is here. Pick a number less than 1, plug into here. Does it work? Let's say plug in negative 1 into here. That's negative 2 times negative 1. That will give us positive result. We're looking for negative, so it doesn't work. Pick a number between 0 and 1, let's say maybe 1 half. Plug in here, that's negative 1 half. Times 1 half, the result is negative. Lastly, pick a number bigger than 1. I know you are going to say 2. Yes, I'm going to pick 2 as well. Plug into here is 1 times 2. Of course, that's positive 2. As you can see, we are looking for negative. So it's this part right here. We want to care about 1 and 0 because you see that we have the greater, you have the less than or equal to. So technically, you want to include this and that. However, remember, we have this node right here. Y cannot be 1. So I actually have to get rid of that. So all in all, we see that we care about this portion, which is y has to be in between of 0 and less than 1, not including 1. And therefore, this right here is our range of the function. I'm just going to write it like this. Depends on how you want to write it. You can say the set notation or whatnot. I think usually the inequality will work already. So just like that. So that's it. I'll box the whole thing right here.